What's going on, guys? My name is Solomon and I am super excited to bring this video to guys today, because in this video I'm going to show you how to maintain computer hardwares. Before starting the lesson, please subscribe my channel. When updating new video, you get notification for you. That much to do, let's get started. Okay, computer maintenance. What does that mean, computer maintenance mean? Computer maintenance is fixing hardware and software problem. Before maintaining the computers, first you have to identify or you have to know each hardware parts and software parts of computer systems. So what does that mean, hardware? Hardware is the physical parts of a computer systems. You can see by our naked eye and you can touch the hardware parts of a computer system. Whereas software is a set of programs or instructions that can perform specific tasks. So generally, hardware is found inside the case or system unit and outside the case. So outside the system unit, here you do have a keyboard. This is one hardware part of a computer system, an input device. And also here you do have the screens or monitors. This is an output device. And also mouse, also it is external hardware device of a computer system. Inside the system case or the system unit, here you have different components or hardware components of a computer systems inside the system unit. So we can see one by one. In computer system, there are four operations performed. The first one is input operation, output operation, processing operation, and the last one is storage operation. In order to perform the input operation, you must have use input devices, and also output operation use output devices. For processing operation, there is a processing device, and for a storage operation, there is a storage device. So there are different, what does that mean, input device? Input device is used to send information into the computer systems, such as the best examples of input device are keyboard and mouse. Mouse is a pointing device used to pointing some things. And also keyboard is, it is an input device used to send information into the computer system. It's to send some texts from keyboard into the computer system. This is an input device. And also there are another input device like scanners. Scanner is used to accept the hard document and convert into soft copy. This is also an input device. And also web camera is an input device. Microphone also an input device. Input device generally is used to send information into the computer system. The other is output device. Output device is a device that can display the information to the users, like a screen. Screen is the best, or monitor is the best examples of an output device. It is to display the information here, and also printer also an output device is to print the soft copy into hard one, and also speaker also an output device is to display the audio sound and increasing sounds. Those are the output device. And also the other is storage device. A storage device can be classified into two primary storage device and secondary storage device. Primary storage device is used to store information temporarily or a short period of time, whereas secondary storage device is used to store information for a long period of time until to delete it. So the best examples of primary storage device is RAM and ROM. RAM is used to store information temporarily, used to write and read information, write into files and read from files the information or data, whereas ROM is read only memory, used to reading the data. The other is secondary storage device. Secondary storage devices can be classified into two: magnetic secondary storage device and optical secondary storage device. Magnetic secondary storage device is used to store information permanently in a magnetic mechanism, like hard disk is the best examples of magnetic secondary storage device, and also tape drive is floppy disk. Tape drive is another magnetic secondary storage devices. Here you do have hard disk, 500 GB hard disk, used to store information permanently until to delete after saving the files. The files stored here in magnetic secondary storage device that is called as hard disk. The other one is processing device. Processing device is used to processing the information. Assume when giving inputs 1 plus 2 displaying 3. After processing, displaying 3 into output device. So one type of processing device is CPU. CPU stands for Central Processing Unit. Always think, processing the information. This is found in the system board, inside the system unit. Here you do have the system board or motherboard. On the center of the motherboard, here you do have the central processing unit or CPU. It's due to processing the information. So this is CPU. CPU is used to process information. There are basically two units: arithmetic logic unit and control unit. Arithmetic logic unit is used to calculate or operate mathematical and logical operations like addition, subtraction, division, and multiplication, and also logical operations like AND gate, NOR gate, NOT gate, NAND gate, NOR, XNOR, something operations or gates performed by control units. Sorry, arithmetic logic unit. Arithmetic logic unit generally performs arithmetic and logical operations. The other one is control unit. Control units of a CPU is used to control all machine cycles. So this is a processing or CPU used to processing the information. There are different types of processors. Same you have Intel processors or Core i processors, AMD processors, different types of processors. So the other is power supply. Inside the system is found in inside the system unit. Here you have power supply. Power supply exists to supply of power, accepting the powers from external sources. Assume there is a 240 voltage amounts of voltages coming from externals, and accepting that powers here, there is plug in the power cable here, and also storing the powers and distribute inside all components of the computer systems. All components uses powers in order to perform operations, use powers directly and indirectly. So power supply is the supply of powers and also act as like transformers, rectifiers. Act as a transformers, accepting or alternative current, converting to direct current. If the amount of voltage is increased, the transformer is decrease that voltage. If it is increased, decrease the amount of voltage. So act as a the power supply act as a transformers and rectifiers. You need to distribute the powers for each internal components of the computer systems directly and indirectly, directly through these ATX cables. This is ATX cables. It is to distribute the powers to the motherboard. And also here you have different cables for hard disk, and also this is for CD drive. And also secondary storage device is magnetic and analytical or opticals. Optical secondary storage devices are, the first one is CD and DVD. Secondary storage devices, as you know, store the information permanently. So optical secondary storage device is used to store the information permanently until to delete. Like CD and DVD is an example of optical secondary storage device. Here you have CD used to store informations like in GB or in megabyte. There is different types of CD or compact disc used to store information permanently. Here you have a CD, and also the other is DVD, digital versatile disc is another example of optical secondary storage device. The difference between magnetic and optical storage device. Magnetic storage device is large in size when comparing to opticals. Assume here you have a hard disk, 500 GB hard disk, but in CD it may be in GB. So the size of hard disk is larger than CD. This is the difference, but the similarity is easy to store information permanently. Okay, here the motherboard or motherboard is used to place all components of internal components of the computer system. Here you have RAM slots, DMI or DMIM or DIMM slots here, double inline memory module slots. You have to plug the RAMs here. Here is a RAM slot, and also here you have to plug or put the CPU or central processing units. Always think, it is a processing device, it is a brain of computers. Here you have to put here or plug here the CPU. And the other is different capacitors. Here you do have different capacitors. Those capacitors used to store charge. And the other one is different slots. Here you do have different slots, input output or peripheral device or slots. Here you have to plug here, and also here you do have different ports. There are two types of ports: male port and female ports. So here you have different USB flashes you have to plug here, and also here you have the serial ports. This is a serial port, this is serial port, this is VGA, video graphics arrays, and here you have the audio ports and earphones. Here you have two earphones, and also here you have parallel ports, different parallel ports here, and also the connection ports. Here you have a connection ports. So those are the system port components, and also here you have the BIOS or basic input output device, and also here you have CMOS battery, complementary metallic oxide semiconductor battery used to control the system clock. This control system clock. This is CMOS battery. Here you have plug here on the mother ports. There are different components or internal parts of the computer system is placed on the motherboards. There are different components here, so you need to place all components. And the other one is, this is PCI cards, so plug in here. And also the other inside parts of the computer system is fan, computer fan. Computer fan is used to cooling the computer or the internal parts of, or cooling the internal parts of the computer systems or cooling the computers. This is fans or CPU fans. There are two types. So basically there are three fans. Here you have the power supply fans inside here. And also, this is the CPU fans. Under the CPU fans, there is a sinkers. Sinkers is to sink or cool the CPU. This is CPU, and under here, there is a coolers. Here, the white color is coolers. So, when you ventilate the fans, then cooling the sink or heat sinkers that are cooling here the processing device that is called a CPU. And The other is case fan. Case fan is here you have case fans used to cooling the internal parts of the computer systems. Fan used to cooling the computer system. So here you have speakers. This is a small speakers for desktop computers. This is an speaker used to increase the audio sound or the audio or music used to enlarge the sound. So here you do have different cables. For assume for example for keyboard, for mouse. Here you have peripheral input-output cables. Here is a port. And here you have to plug the USB flash drive, and also input-output device like keyboard, mouse, and also others. So those are cables, and also these are the SATA cables used to store information or transfer information from system board to hard disk, and also from system board to the CD or compact disk by using these cables or SATA cables or data cables to transfer information or data from system board to hard disk or from compact disk. Those are the introduction parts of the computer hardware. So please subscribe my channel. When uploading new video, you get notification for. Thank you for watching.